Let's assume you own this store and you're selling t-shirts for $5 each. $5 is the sale price of the t-shirts. We bought the first t-shirt for $1, the second for $2, and the third for $3. This is our cost to get the t-shirts to our store. Let's assume we have three t-shirts that we sell. This lady down here wants to buy the first t-shirt that we have bought. Our revenue is $5 because the lady has to pay $5 to get the shirt. However, our cost is $1. Gross profit, therefore, is $4. This method is called specific identification because we specifically identify which t-shirt the lady bought. Now, let's assume that instead of three, we're selling thousands of shirts. Do you think that anybody would have the resources and time to specifically identify which shirt was picked up by their customers? Well, chances are, you're not Superman. So to be more efficient, we have to rely on assumptions. First assumption is FIFO, first in, first out. The products that we buy first are the first to be sold. Second is LIFO, products that we buy last are the first to be sold. And finally, we have average cost method. We find the average cost of each shirt and we apply it to each sale that we make. Under FIFO, first in, first out, whatever we bought first is the first to be sold. Let's say this guy picked up the second shirt. He has to pay $5, which is our revenue. Our cost of goods sold is not $2 because we do not care which shirt he picked up. We assume he picked up the first one that we have bought, so our cost is $1. Under LIFO, whatever we bought last is the first to be sold. Let's say this guy picks up the second shirt. He has to pay $5, our revenue. Our cost of goods sold is not $2 because we do not care which shirt he picked up. We assume he picked up the last one that we have bought. Our cost is $3. Under the average cost method, we simply find the average cost per shirt. We do not care which t-shirt this guy picked. The average cost is calculated to be $2 per shirt. And that is our cost of goods sold. Therefore, the gross profit is $3. Now let's compare the three methods. The revenue is the name under all three. Since the selling price is 5 per shirt, now the cost of goods sold is 1, 3 and 2 respectively, which ends into a different gross profit. That means under FIFO you will pay the highest taxes, under LIFO the lowest. Let's assume you're selling these light bulbs and you're using the FIFO method. At the start of the year you had 20 units at the price of 10 and you purchased 10 more at the price of 11. We know we have sold 15 units. So what is the cost of goods sold and ending inventory? Let's see. Since under FIFO what we bought first is the first to be sold, we will assume we have sold 15 units which were purchased at the price of 10, which gives us total of 150. The ending inventory is what we have left, that is 5 units at 10 and 10 units at 11. Let's solve the same problem but now using LIFO. The same beginning inventory and the same purchases. Again, we have sold 15 units. Find the cost of goods sold and the ending inventory. Let's see how that works out. So under LIFO, whatever we have bought last is the first to be sold. Since we have sold 15 units, that means we have sold 10 units at the price of 11. We bought this last, remember? And 5 units at the price of 10, for a total of 160. The ending inventory is what we have left, that is 15 units at the $10. Let's solve the same problem but now using the average cost method. Same beginning inventory, 20 units at $10, same purchases, 10 units at 11. Again, we have sold 15 units. Find the cost of goods sold and ending inventory. We first have to find the average cost per unit. To find that, we need to find the total cost, which is 20 at 10 and 10 units at $11. That adds up to 310. Divided by 30 units total, it is $10 per unit cost. So the cost of goods sold of 15 sold units is 15 times that price. Okay, I hope you understood, guys. Thank you for listening. Created using Powtoon.